Welcome to Enter the Unknown. My name is FJ, and today we're going to be starting our brand new random card challenge series in Pokemon Heart Gold. There are going to be some changes from the first series, so let me explain how this is going to work. I ordered some random cards online hoping for lots of second gen Pokemon to go through Johto, but we got a real mixed bag. After going through all of them, I realized that I had just enough unique Pokemon that I could draw a completely different team for every battle in the 4th gen Johto remakes. Without all of the duplicates though, we've actually got a really good amount of decent Pokemon to draw from, along with the usual, less useful Pokemon. So, to spice up Pokemon Heart Gold and up the difficulty level, I've mixed things up in the Universal Pokemon Randomizer. Every single trainer will have a completely random team, with the kicker being that any Pokemon level 30 or higher will be randomized into a fully evolved Pokemon. This will make it so we don't end up facing off against Red with a team of weak Pokemon. We might face some easier challenges early on, but we could equally run into Arceus in the first gym. The basic concept from the first random card challenge hasn't changed though. We'll be drawing a new team for every major battle, matching levels with our opponent, and then facing off against them in a set battle without the use of items. I'm not going to go through all of the cards on screen because there are 126 of them, but here are all the holographic cards that came in the packs, and if you want to see the full selection, I'll leave a list in the description. It is still mostly first gen Pokemon, but we've got a pretty decent selection including a few legendaries like Mewtwo, Magikarp, and Regice. If I pick the right Team Rocket battles to include, then I think we'll have the exact number of cards to leave us with just 6 Pokemon remaining when we reach Red. For the moment though, we've still got our entire deck to draw from, so let's pick our starter. We're gonna be using Duskull for the first rival battle with Silver, but before we get to that, we've got to meet up with Professor Elm. The Johto Pokemon Professor asks us to choose a partner and head to meet Mr. Pokemon in his place. We agree and pick up our brand new Duskull and nickname her Scully. After heading out of New Barktown and through Cherry Grove, we reach Mr. Pokemon's house on Route 30. While we're doing that, our rival is busy robbing Professor Elm's Pokemon lab, so that's good. Luckily, Mr. Pokemon is feeling generous and offers us a nice egg in this trying time. On our way back to New Barktown, we cross paths with Silver, who's keen to show off his new Pokemon. I considered drawing a starter for him to have, but I'm pretty sure the randomizer would have changed it, so we're going in completely blind. For the first battle of the series, we've got Duskull at level 5, with the moves Nightshade and Leer. Let's hope Silver didn't steal a normal type. Okay, let's find out. He sends out his Weezing, okay, and we send in Scully. Weezing doesn't have any great moves and has to attack Duskull with the not very effective Smog. Nightshade deals damage equal to Scully's level, so each of her hits are good for 5 HP. Mid-battle, Silver switches up his strategy and instructs Weezing to use Smokescreen, but without being able to hurt Duskull, he's got no chance of winning. The Requiem Pokemon takes down Weezing with Nightshade, handing us the first win of the series, and honestly, it was an incredibly easy one. We need to head back to the lab, but after that our next destination is the Violet City Gym. We're gonna need a team of 2 for the battle with Faulkner, and it looks like we'll be using Psyduck and Oddish. Now, here's hoping the gym leader doesn't in fact have an Arceus. The point is, we don't have a great team, so we're gonna need a bit of luck here. For the Violet City Gym battle, Ilex the Oddish is at level 13 with the moves Absorb, Sweet Scent, Acid, and Poison Powder. The other half of our team, Dakota the Psyduck, is at level 9 and her moveset consists of Scratch, Tail Whip, Water Sport, and Water Gun. Right, let's go get our first gym badge. Faulkner starts out with Cyndaquil, so I definitely made the right choice by sending out Oddish first. The one major advantage I had in the first series of the random card challenge was always knowing what our opponent would lead off with. This time I don't have that, so it's going to make things a lot more difficult with the set battle style. We burn a turn switching out to Psyduck, and the Johto Firestarter uses Leer. That really seems to be all he can do. Another Leer is followed by a Water Gun that seriously weakens the fire type. Knowing that Cyndaquil has one last chance to deal some damage and get back into the battle, Faulkner calls for the Fire Mouse to use Leer. This is Gary and his future side obsession all over again. Dakota fires a second jet of water Cyndaquil's way, knocking him out and leaving Faulkner with just his ace. The Violet Gym Leader's second Pokemon is Ponyta, which makes him a pretty realistic first city fire type gym leader. We recall Psyduck because of all the Leers and send Oddish back into battle. After getting hit by Tackle, Ilex successfully poisons Ponyta, and at this point it's really clear that Faulkner's confused. The Fire Horse Pokemon definitely knows Ember, but the elegant master of Fire Pokemon keeps calling for Growl and Tail Whip. In the meantime, Oddish continues attacking with Acid, and without getting a second hit in, Ponyta succumbs to the poison. We've beaten Faulkner and earned the Zephyr badge, so as far as I'm concerned, this whole series is a massive success. We're going to try to go for two gym badges in this episode though, so let's leave Violet City and make our way to Azalea Town. We go through Union Cave on the path to our next opponent, Proton. The Rocket Executive has brought his group to Slowpoke Well, and they're cutting the tails off Slowpokes, which is pretty worrying behavior. We need to draw two cards for our battle with Proton, so let's see who we're going to be using. First up, we've got Electrike. This card is amazing, by the way, and Executor. That's a really solid team, so let's get back into the game and have a look. Quasar the Electrike is at level 8 with the moves Tackle and Thunder Wave. I wish we had an electric type attack, but at least Thunder Wave should come in handy. The second member of our team is Xylem the Executor, and she's at level 12 with a moveset featuring Confusion, Hypnosis, Barrage, and Stomp. Xylem's ability is Chlorophyll, which will boost her speed in the sunshine, which will definitely come into play in the bottom of an underground cave. Right, let's jump into this absolute nightmare scenario and climb down into the Slowpoke Well. When we reach Proton, we send an Electrike, and he leads off with Feraligatr. An electric type attack would be really nice right about now. Quasar starts the battle by paralyzing the fully evolved Water Starter with Thunder Wave while Proton calls for Leer. I'm starting to see a pattern in this game. Electrike gets to work with Tackle while Feraligatr just uses Leer over and over again. Quasar continues to charge at the Big Jaw Pokemon who finally attacks, and with all of the Leering, Scratch almost scores a knockout. Electrike gets off one final tackle before a crit Water Gun washes her away and gives Proton the first win of the match. Executor comes in on our side, and even though we don't have a grass type move, it doesn't really matter. Feraligatr is paralyzed, so Xylem outspeeds him and wipes him out with Confusion. Proton sends out his Pelipper, and we're at a bit of a disadvantage with his partial flying type. Supersonic confuses Executor, but she breaks through and fires back with Confusion. It cuts away a bit less than half of Pelipper's HP before a wing attack hits Xylem hard. The grass and psychic type stomps on the Waterbird Pokemon, leaving him in one shot range before another wing attack takes her into orange health. Breaking through Confusion yet again, Executor uses another psychic type attack to finish off Pelipper and hand us the win. If Xylem had hit herself in Confusion even once, then we definitely would have lost, so we really got lucky here. With Team Rocket cleared out of Azalea Town, it's time for our second gym battle. Bugsy uses a team of 3 in the Azalea Gym, so that's how many team members we need to draw. It looks like we're going to be using the trio of Plusle, Zubat, and Jigglypuff. This isn't an amazing team, and if Bugsy's got a strong group, we're in serious trouble. Let's check out the team. Adeecee the Plusle is at level 15 with Quick Attack, Growl, Thunder Wave, and Spark. Balsa the Zubat's also at 15, and he's got Leech Life, Supersonic, Astonish, and Bite. Finally, we've got Kanta the Jigglypuff, who's at level 17 with the moves Pound, Defense Curl, Sing, and Roll Out. The levels for this one were really convenient, with Plusle learning Spark at level 15 and Jigglypuff learning Roll Out at level 17. Okay, let's get our second gym battle going. Bugsy leads off with his highest level Pokemon Gloom, and we start out with Plusle. The two trade off Paralysis moves to begin, with Thunder Wave and Stun Spore both landing. It's not a great matchup for us, so we recall Adeecee and send in Zubat to replace him. After taking a resisted acid attack, Balsa uses Supersonic to confuse the drooling weed Pokemon. Zubat then goes on a tear while Gloom's confused, attacking with Bite and Leech Life while she repeatedly fails to break through the confusion. When she eventually snaps out of it, Stun Spore paralyzes Zubat, but she doesn't have any useful attacks and is forced to use acid. Supersonic confuses the grass and poison type again, and the two paralyzed Pokemon go back and forth with their attacks. Eventually, Gloom manages to knock Balsa into red health with a crit acid before an equally critical Bite finally gives us the first win of the battle. Bugsy sends in his Elekid second, and knowing that Balsa won't be able to do much with the paralysis and low HP, we leave him in and a quick attack knocks him out. That lets us freely switch out to Kanta, and she absorbs a Thundershock before putting Elekid to sleep with Sing. We go for Defense Curl to power up our next move while simultaneously boosting Jigglypuff's defense, and then go straight into Rollout. The baby Pokemon can't wake up and is knocked out by two hits of the Rolling Rock attack. Bugsy's down to his final team member, and when he sends out Ninjask, it's as good as done. The bug outspeeds Kanta to land Sand Attack and increase the likelihood that Rollout won't connect, but it's no use. The third run of Rollout cracks Ninjask, knocking her out in one and handing us the win. With the Hive Badge added to our case, we can make our way out of Azalea Town, but I'm gonna save that for next time. We've had a couple of challenges so far, but this is going to start getting incredibly difficult once all of our opponents start using fully evolved Pokemon. We're still a few gyms away from reaching that point though. Okay, that's going to do it for the first episode of the new series of the Random Card Challenge. I really hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.